The test number 8 is Modern India Part 2 and Current Affairs for the month of July 2020. Okay. Let me start with the orientation for Modern India. So the second part consists of pre-Congress political parties, moderates and extreme phase, Swadeshi movement, revolutionary movement, arrival of Gandhi, non-cooperation, civil disobedience movements, the Simon Commission, roundtable conferences, 1935 election, the transfer of power issues, and the trade union movement, communalism, other political parties, famous personalities, constitutional developments, tribal and peasant uprisings, all these were the parts that we are going to see here in this orientation. Okay. As I told you in the first part of orientation history, here also I am saying that I have taken 25 years of question paper as a criteria. What are the types of questions they have asked? Okay. I'm not going to discuss the questions as like that in the case of the orientation which I have given in part one. Here I'm going to what type of questions they may ask, in what sense they are asking the questions. That is what we are going to see here. Okay. So the first one, pre-Congress political parties, early leaders and their contributors. Two sections are there. Pre-Congress political parties. Pre-Congress political parties. Pre-Congress political parties. This is one section there. In this section, you just understand what are the pre-Congress political parties that were emerged. You have to start it with the Indian National Association. Indian National Association. Indian Association. Indian Association. It's not Indian Nation. You don't understand it as Indian National Army. We people understand like that only. Indian National Association. Indian Association. Association. Okay. like that, the political parties that were existed, that is Bombay Presidency Association, Bombay, Madras. I have combined the two, both here. Presidency Association. Association. Okay. East Indian Association. The East Indian Association, like that, etc., etc. Here. See, in this area, what are the things you have to focus here is, one thing you have to understand, the chronology. Chronology. The chronology of these associations. The chronology of this association, which was started earlier, which was started later. Later means before Indian National Congress. You need to understand it here. Okay. So the chronology of these associations, which were started earlier, that is one thing, first thing. And then objectives. Objectives of the associations are aims. That is another thing you have to focus it. Another thing you have to focus it. Next one here, the personalities associated with this. Personalities. Personalities. Personality. Don't concentrate all the personalities. Some associations have 15 members. You don't need to memorize. You don't need to look up all those 15 personalities. Only the president, secretary of the association. Okay, clear. That is one thing. And the another one, magazine, newspaper associated with these associations. So these things you have to focus. One is chronology of these associations. And the another one, what were the objectives of the association? Some were for the civil service age reduction. Some were for the legislature. Zamindari Association, like this. What were the objectives and the aims? And the personalities who were involved in those associations. You focus only on the president and the secretary of the association. That is enough there. And any magazine or newspaper that it is associated with it. Any magazine or newspaper are associated with these institutions. That is the association. This is enough here. In the last 25 years of question paper, most of the questions they have asked here is with the objectives and the aims. This is one area where they have asking the question. And another area, the personalities, they are asking the questions. Personalities. This is. Here and there, they are associated with the magazines. But most of the questions they asked here is the Zamindari Association. What is the objective of the Zamindari Association? They included it with the one of the statement. That means the Zamindari Association's objective was to protect the rights of the Zamindar. That was the thing. It fought for the civil service age reduction. Like this, they would try to trick you. So you clearly read what are the objectives. This is the area where they are focusing in the pre-Congress associations. Pre-Congress associations, that is one topic. Pre-Congress political parties, that it was. I have only written four of the things here. Indian National Association, Indian Association, Bombay Madras Presidency Association, and East Indian Association, that is only written here. Zamindari Association we are having, Calcutta Association we are having, East Indian Calcutta Association we are having. Like that, we are having a lot of associations there. Okay, you just concentrate on those things. Very popular question. Madras and Bombay Presidency Association that was involved with the personalities. The Trimurates with the Bombay Presidency Association and the Madras and the personalities associated with the Madras Presidency Association. These are the repeated area in the questions where they are keep on asking. Okay, so that is one area. This is one important area where they are asking the questions. This is one important area where they are keep on asking the questions. Okay. This is one thing. Next one is yearly leaders and their contribution. Within the first topic itself, another section there. Yearly leaders and their contributions. Yearly leaders and their contributions. Here, yearly leaders and the contributions. Where we have to start with the yearly leaders and the contributions here. So here, you start with Rajaram Mohan Roy. Rajaram Mohan Roy. Even though he is associated with the social reform movement, he is one of the first political man in India. He is one of the first political awakener here in India. So, from Rajaram Mohan Roy till the Indian National Congress personalities. See, that is with 1815. Rajaram Mohan Roy is associated with Atmiya Sabha. That is the first social reform association that was started here. We start with that and with the Indian National Congress period 1885. In this era, from 1815 to 1885, what are the associations and their leaders, that is what they are asking. Yearly leaders and their contributions. Leaders and their contribution. Contribution. This area is overlapping with the social reform movement also. But anyhow, for our test, it is like a watertight compartment. We are not going to ask any questions from the social. Maybe, because already you have studied the chapter, maybe it have overlap here. I'm sorry, we can get in the questions, some questions here and there, you can get it. Because this area we have, we cannot separate this area with the social reform movement. it is an overlapping area. Without social reform, we cannot expect the political reform. So that's why already our social reform was matured enough. Already for after that only we are having the political reform. We have the political achievements in India. Okay, so that is the thing. So early leaders and their contributions here, early leaders, till Indian National Congress Association founding. Okay, so the leaders and their contribution, 1815 to 1885, I told you. So the personalities, their contribution, that is mostly they are asking. Political contribution, social contribution, magazine, that is magazine, editorial contribution, all these things you have to take it down here. Okay, so contribution means here political contribution, social contribution, and then magazine, related to magazine, newspaper, editor, like that you have to take it down. Okay, this is one area where they keep on asking the question. Here only they would ask the question, Gokhale, they would ask you. Here they ask you the questions of Firoza Mehta, even though he's the early moderators. Like this, the questions are associated here only. They're asking that question from here only. Clear? Okay, next one. Next topic is face of moderates and extremists. Okay. Moderates and extremist face. Moderates and extremist. Okay. I combined these two things because both of the thing is same only. Same only. The way of studying is same here. See here, what you have to focus here is... okay, the moderates and the extremists. What are the similarities between the two? Similarities and the dissimilarities between the two. What are the similarities and the dissimilarities between the two? That we need to clearly understand. Even though it seems to be like a mains topic, it seems to be like a mains area. That is what they are expecting you in the statement type of question. Similarities and the dissimilarities. And their ideologies. Ideology of the two. Moderates ideology. Extremist ideology. What were their objectives? Objectives. Or aims. Aims of them. Moderates and extremists aim. Next one. The personalities. Personalities. The personalities here. Already you come across there in the ideology itself. And the personality is also associated with the ideology. For example, Feroz Shah Mehta ideology, Tilak ideology, Arvind Ghosh ideology, Gokhale ideology, like that they may ask you. Okay. So that is integrated here. Both the things are integrated. Personalities and the ideology of moderates is integrated here in this topic. Okay. Personalities and the area they belong to, area or zone, area we can take it as north. Area means western part of India, eastern part of India, southern part of India, northwest part of India. That type of question there we can expect it. Okay, so this is what the moderates and extremists they are asking here. Okay, if you take last 25 years of question paper, they keep on repeatedly asking the questions in the similarities and the dissimilarities area. This is where we can expect the question. Keep on repeating. Every 2 years once they are keep on asking the question. That is, moderates, this they did it. Dissimilarity, that is similarity, dissimilarity means this is the, ideologically they are asking there. And ideologically is another area they keep on asking the question, ideologically. This is another area. and then objectives and aims is also important. In this topic, all the things are important. Moderates and extremists is one of the most important topic because it is a regular area where they are keep on asking the question. In the last 25 years, if you go on through the question paper, you can able to understand it. You can able to understand it. They keep on asking the question. Okay. Here you have to focus it like this. Focus it like that. Clear? Okay. So that's about the moderates and the extremists. Clear. Next one. The next topic. Swadeshi movement. Swadeshi movement. Next thing is Swadeshi movement. Swadeshi movement. Here in the Swadeshi movement, what were the ideology of the Swadeshi movement? Ideology, objective, and then personalities. Swadeshi movement area, whether it was in North India, South India, only Eastern India, like this thing. Okay. This is another area the question is keep on asking. And another one, the Swadeshi movement consequences. Or we called it as impact. Impact of what? Impact of Indian National Movement. INM. INM means Indian National Movement. So what is it? This is one area. Another area they are keep on asking. If you take last 25 years of question paper, they are asking the personalities. This area they keep on asking. And area they can asking in statement. Tricking. They try to trick you. Swadeshi movement. It was spreaded there in the northern part of India. It was spreaded there in the eastern part of India. Like that, they are keep on asking the question. And another one, regarding the Swadeshi movement, objective, ideology, here also resolution, objective and resolution. This is another area they keep on asking the question. Very popular question. Who moved the resolution? Who moved the resolution? Where they moved the resolution? In a statement, they are asking the question. Okay, Swadeshi movement, this type of questions they are asking. Okay, this is another area. Most important area, they are asking the question. And nowadays, in the last six years of question paper, consequences, impact they are asking and connected with the modern national movement. This is the emerging area in the prelims level, because UPSC is testing the students whether they have studied in depth or not in certain topics. This is one topic where UPSC is testing the students whether they have in depth understanding knowledge or not. The consequences, because usually we skip the consequences in the earlier, but now it is not possible because that is the area where they are asking the questions. In the last 6 years of question paper, if you see that in the Swadeshi movement, what were the consequences? Because what were the consequences? That is the impact they are connecting here with national movement. They are connecting it because Swadeshi movement is a starting point of all our national movement. This area they keep on asking the questions. Clear? Okay. Next one. Period of revolutionary movement. Revolutionary movements in India. Periods of revolutionary movement. Here in the revolutionary movement, we have to start with the phases of revolutionary movement. Phases are 1895 to 1907. 1932 and Quit India Movement 1942. It is complete revolutionary thing, 1942. So here the phases, what are the, here you have to understand what is the concept of each and every phase, concept of phases. Concept of the phases, because here we use one concept, here one concept, here one concept, why here in concept. So what are the concept involved there? What are the concept involved there in each and every phase of the revolutionary movement? This is one thing we need to understand, and we have to understand that is what the questions is asking. And the another one is concept of the phases are, or you can say it. Okay. I will write then one more thing. No problem that. Concept or ideology. Ideology, you can write it. Ideology of the phases. Each and every phase, ideology. Next one, most important, personalities. Personalities associated. Personalities associated. And here, not only the personalities associated, assassinations associated. Assassinations. Assassinations. That is. Here, in the periods of revolutionary movement, factual information is most important here. Here. Except this concept, here in these two areas, we need to understand the facts. Facts. Who involved in what association? Yugantar. Hindustan Socialist Army. Hindustan Socialist Republic Army. HSRA. Surya Sen's Association. Revolutionary Association. Like that, personalities associated. Who were that personalities? Fact. Associated from where? Which association? Personality associated with the association, that is most important. And what are the assassinations they did it? Curzon, Willy. Like that, we need to have the information, factual information. So here, in the periods of revolutionary association or the revolutionary movement, you focus, except the concept and ideology, more factual information you need to gather. You need to focus more on factual informations. Personalities associated with what? In which year? Who killed whom? Like that, you need to focus. So that is, this you have to focus in the factual information. In the last 25 years of question paper, if you take it, most of the questions they are asking here is from the personalities associated. This area they are keep on asking. And conceptually, they're asking. This is also one of the most important. This is one of the most important. Clear? Okay. Next thing. Arrival of Gandhi, his early success in South Africa, and his experiments in India. Three topics are there. Arrival of Gandhi. That is one topic. And the another one is yearly success in South Africa. This is connected. Yearly success. In South Africa. This is one topic. And the another one, that is experiments in India, yearly experiments in India. So, in this topic, three things are interconnected. three things are interconnected. Arrival of Gandhi. What is the concept behind the arrival of Gandhi? Concept. You understand, that is enough here. For prelims level, conceptually understand here. Success of Gandhi in South Africa. Here, what was his ideology? Ideology regarding non-violence. Non-violence. Because first thing, he used this non-violence in South Africa only. Because of that success in South Africa, he is going to implement this non-violence here in India, Ahimsa. That is non-violence Ahimsa. Ideology, Ahimsa. Ahimsa. And his early success in South Africa is mentioned in the syllabus. So here, personalities associated. Personalities associated with Gandhi. Associated with Gandhi in South Africa. South Africa. Clear? Next one. Early experiments in India. Champaran, Kheda, Ahmedabad, Mill strike. These things. Here, in this Champaran, Kheda, Ahmedabad mill strike, you concentrate on reason. I write here. Wait. Reason. The reason for each and every satyagraha. Reason. Personality is associated. And then, consequences of this one. Consequences of this. Early experiments. So, if you take the past few years of question paper, 25 years of question paper, most of the question focused here only. Champaran, Kheda, and then Ahmedabad mill strike. What is the reason for Champaran Satyagraha? What is the reason for Ahmedabad mill strike? They are asking in the statement. And the personalities associated with that. What were the consequences of this Satyagraha? Like this, they are keep on asking. Here, arrival of Gandhi and the success in South Africa, very rare and rarest case only they are asking this question. Okay. I will tell you the source of information for this topic only. That is, early success in South Africa ideology. This topic only I am saying. For this topic, you read the Modern India Freedom Struggle. What is that book? Okay, this Bipin Chandra textbook, you take it. That is what I try to tell you. India Struggle for Indian Independence. In this book, India Struggle for Indian Independence. In this book, India Struggle for Indian Independence. The textbook. India Struggle for Indian Independence. This part, this book. You read for this topic. This early success in South Africa. 3 or 5 pages would be there. And that will give the understanding to you. Okay. So, this topic, you refer there. Okay. So, that is the reference for this book. Why I have not tell any other reference book for the earlier topics means, wait, I will tell you. Particularly, I am saying this means this is the only area you have to refer in this book only. Okay. So, next thing, non-cooperation movement and temple entry movement. Non-cooperation, NCM, and temple entry movement. Temple entry movement. Okay. So here, non-cooperation movement, same thing. Same thing as I told you earlier. objective of the non-cooperation movement, and then personalities associated with the non-cooperation movement, and the areas of non-cooperation movement, that is enough here, and the consequences of non-cooperation movement. Consequences. This is not only for the non-cooperation movement and also for the civil disobedience movement. This is also for the civil disobedience movement, CDM. Both of the things are same here. Because ideologically, CDM, civil disobedience movement, both of the thing concepts are same. And one more thing in non-cooperation movement and civil disobedience movement, parallel governments, Pradi Sarkar, you come across Tamulk area, Balasore area, you come across that in the modern India. Okay, so this is, see, this area, they are keep on asking the question. Mostly they are asking the questions related to personalities and areas. This is most important. And here parallel government is important. And this is also important. Objectives, non-cooperation, civil disobedience, that is not much objective there. And that is a simple only, we can able to understand it here. Okay. So here personalities and areas is a factual information. Facts. This is facts. This is concept. Nowadays they are asking the concepts or the consequences only, they are focusing more. Okay. So that area they are asking. Okay. This is non-cooperation movement and civil disobedience movement. Both the thing. Temple entry movement. All the thing. Clear? Okay. That's about that civil disobedience movement. Developments of Government of India Act 1935. So, okay, following this one, civil disobedience movement. Following the civil disobedience movement, we are having Simon Commission 1, and then a Roundtable Conference, RTCs, Roundtable Conferences 1, 2, 3, and then Pune Pact. Pune Pact. Instead of Pune Pact, we can say that. Communal Award. Pune Pact. Pune Pact. All these things. Here, in all these things, in all this thing, you have to focus on what are the objectives. Objective of Simon Commission or reason. Okay, we can say reason. Reason, objectives later. Reason. What is the reason for Simon Commission? First thing, reason. Or we can say causes. Causes behind. What were the reasons for the Simon Commission? What were the reasons behind the Roundtable Conference? What were the reasons for the Communal Award? What were the reasons for the Pune Pact? That is one thing. And then, next one, personalities associated. Who were the personalities associated with the Roundtable Conference 1, 2, 3? Who are the personalities associated with the Communal Award? Who are the personalities associated with the Pune Pact? Like that, they're asking the question. Okay. And what were the objectives of each and everyone? Objective of Simon Commission. What were the objective of RTCs? Like this. Okay. So, and then consequences of each and everyone. Consequences. Consequences to Indian National Movement. Clear? Okay, so this is one important area. This is one important area. They keep on asking the question. They keep on asking the question. Or they can ask you chronological order also here. Chronological order. Chronology. Chronological order. Okay. So this is the thing we have to focus it here. Okay. Next thing, elections. 1935 election formations in the Congress ministry. Okay, that is another area. Okay, okay. See here. The last 25 years, the questions is keep on asking here in the all the areas they keep on asking. All the things they are asking. This area they are asking. Reasons behind that. Personalities associated with the roundtable conferences. Objective. Consequences. All these things. Chronology, we know that. This is the chronological order. So that is 1 or 2 years only in the last 25 years they are asked the question paper regarding the chronological order. Because last year they have asked one chronological orders question. Type of question. So we can expect the chronological order type of question hereafter. Okay. So this is the thing. Next one is Congress Ministry 1937. Here, factual information is enough here. Congress Ministry. State, province, province, majority or minority, majority or minority, and another factual information, who was the premier, because we are not chief minister. We don't have the chief minister there. They call it as a premier only. So who was the premier? That is enough here. What is the Congress ministry? Where all the Congress ministry is formed? Whether Congress ministry was a minority or majority? And who were the premiers there? Madras Presidency, who was the premier? Bombay, who was the premier? Central province, who were the premier? And Sindh, who was the premier? Northwest Frontier Province, who was the premier? And Bengal, who was the premier there? Like that, you have to focus on here. So, this is the entire area is a factual informations. Facts. You need to gather the facts only here. Facts only here. If you find, you can find it in spectrum modern India. If you don't find it difficulty or you are having lot of time means, you read the book India Struggle for Indian Independence. You can find it there. 8 or 9 pages there. India Struggle for Indian Independence book. You can find it the entire thing here. India Struggle for Indian Independence book. Indian Independence by Bipin Chandra. Textbook, you find it. That's a textbook. India Struggle for Indian Independence, Bipin Chandra. You find these things there. 8 pages or 9 pages there. You can get the all informations here. This area so far, not much questions is asked in the last 25 years of question paper set. This is one expected area. This is unexplored region for UPSC. This is one unexplored region. So we can expect a lot of questions in this area. Clear? Okay. Only you need to separate it. That's a very easy one. Half an hour or 45 minutes, we can come across this one. Okay. Next thing, transfer of power issues. This is one topic. Here, from 1940 till 1947, we have to focus. This is the most important topic here in the modern India because it starts from Wewal Plan. It starts with August offer. August offer. Cripps Mission. August offer, Cripps mission, and then cabinet mission plan, or we can Rajaji's formula. Formula, and then Desai Liaquat plan, and then Weval plan, Simla conference, and then cabinet mission plan. Cabinet mission plan. After the cabinet mission plan, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. After the cabinet mission plan, we are having Mountbatten plan. Mountbatten plan, and then the last one, 1947 Indian Independence Act. Okay, this is 9 things you have to focus it here. In this focus area, what you have to do is you have to concentrate on the provisions of each and every one. This is most important. Provision. They are keep on asking the questions in the provision. August offer, one thing. What is the provision of the August offer? One thing they include one. For example, they take the one of the Cripps mission provision and they placed it in the August offer. And which one of the statement is not correct, they ask you. Which one is incorrect, they ask you. Like that they are asking. So they try to trick you with the provisions and by replacing one statement with another statement here. By replacing one statement with another statement, they are keep on asking the question. So this area we have to be very careful. This area they are asking regarding the provisions only and the personalities associated. Personalities. Cripps mission, who are the personalities? Cabinet mission plan, who are the personalities? They say Liaquat plan, who are the personalities? Simla conference, who are the personalities associated? So like that, provisions and personalities is most important here. What is the problem in transfer of power? Problem in transfer of power. In transfer of power. Concept. This is concept. We need to understand at the core. This is most important. Sometimes they are asking the chronology also here. Chronology. Chronology also they are asking here. Whether you have understood it chronologically or not. So this is another area where we have to be very careful on the most important topic here. This is the most important area where they keep on asking the question. Double important. Clear? Okay. Next thing. Capitalism, rise of capitalism, rise of capitalism, and here you understand concept, that is enough here. Capitalism, their contribution, capitalism contribution to Indian national movement, capitalism. Next one, communalism they are having, trade union movement. Next topic is trade union movement. Here, concept, concept behind the trade union movement. Concept. What were the concept behind the trade union movement and contribution to Indian national movement? Contribution to Indian national movement and the personalities associated. The personalities associated with the trade union movement. That is most important. Communalism. This topic is mostly for the mains only. And here you understand what is a concept. Concept, that is enough here. Because in the last 25 years of question paper, they are asking only the conceptual only. Nothing more there. Concept only. Main, because this is a mains topic. Okay. So, rise of capitalism, trade union movement, communalism. Here, if you take these three topics, in the last 25 years of question paper, this area is keep on repeating. But we must not ignore these two things because this is unexplored region. So far, capitalism and communalism, they are asking only in the conceptual level only. So we can expect that these are, because this is a peripheral area. This is not the main part of the Indian national movement. This is a peripheral area. You can expect more questions from the peripheral area only. So you concentrate on capitalism and communalism. This is one area. Other political parties during national movement. Other political parties means that is CPI, Communist Party of India, Congress Socialist Party, CSP. Okay. And then Forward Bloc. Okay. The Communist Party. In the Communist only, we have got lot of Marxist and Leninist like that. We are having lot of the thing. So here, what were the ideologies? Ideology of all these parties. Ideology, personalities. Personalities and their objectives. This is enough here. Very popular question here is the Congress Socialist Party, CSP. CSP ideology they keep on asking. The CSP objective they keep on asking. The Congress Socialist Party, CSP's personalities they keep on asking. The president or who are the members associated with that. This is one area they keep on asking the question. Very popular one. Okay. Contribution, that is the constitutional development, another topic. Constitutional developments. Constitutional developments from 1955. All these things, the provisions is most important. This is one important area where they keep on asking the questions. There is no excuse in this. Because I told you, in the first part of modern India orientation itself, this area, in the last 6 years, they keep on asking the question. This is another area in the constitutional development where they keep on asking the questions. This is another area they keep on asking the questions. Clear? Next one. Each by each provisions we have to read it. No problem. No compromise. It's a factual information area only. Next thing. Civil and tribal uprising. civil and tribal uprisings. As I told earlier, area, leader, and the consequences. This is enough here. What is the area? Who was the leader of that? What were the consequences of the civil and tribal uprisings after 1947? After 1947, I told you wrong. After 1857, that is post 1857. This is one thing. And the Kisan movement, Kisan Sabha, and the movement, Kisan Sabha and Kisan movements. Here, in the Kisan Sabha and the Kisan Sabha movement, personalities, that is what they are keep on asking, and objective. That is the thing. That is another thing. Tribal and peasant. Tribal, this is, you change this as I write as tribal and peasant. Okay. Tribal and peasant uprisings post 1857. Post 1857. Area, leader, consequences. That's all. Kisan Sabha movement. That's all. That's all. Okay. So, that's almost all this thing. For the entire topic after 1857, the book you have to refer, all the topics. First thing, you rely on Spectrum Modern India. And NCRT. Old NCRT, Bipin Chandra. Okay, this is enough. Clear? So, that's all. This area, you concentrate more on the peripheral areas. The peripheral fringe areas you concentrate. Peasant movement, tribal movement, capitalism, trade union movement, communalism, other political parties, pre-Congress political parties, like that you concentrate. That area you can get it more questions nowadays. Okay. Thank you very much.